DC fans woke up to some interesting news today. DC Fandome has been split into two events. Let's talk about it. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to Comic Book Nostalgia. I'm CP Nostalgia, and we got a little update on DC Fandome. But first, we wanted to remind everybody, if you're looking for your place for all your comic book news, rumors, and reviews, all while looking for the best and positive in all these characters we love, make sure you hit that like button and press subscribe. Well, we were all on the final countdown to DC Fandome, and then today the guys dropped a huge update on us. Now, this report comes from Deadline, and what they are saying is that DC Fandome is now split into two events. That's right, it's not all going to be on August 22nd. Now, what's going to happen is we're going to get DC Fandome Hall of Heroes on August the 22nd, and then on September the 12th, we will get DC Fandome Explore the Multiverse. So this is how it's going to break down. Hall of Heroes is still this Saturday, August 22nd, and will still start at 10 a.m. Fans will be transported to DC Fandome Hall of Heroes, an epic world designed personally by Jim Lee, featuring programming, panels, and exclusive reveals from a variety of films, TV series, games, comics, and more. DC Fandome Explore the Multiverse will happen on Saturday, September the 12th, also at 10 a.m. But in this case, fans will be able to create their own timeline. And if you already use that scheduling tool, you kind of might be familiar with this already. This will allow you to pick from a lot of the smaller events that were taking place. Basically, fans will now be able to choose their own adventure and will have a bit more time to immerse themselves in all the content they're creating. DC Kids Fandome will also launch on September the 12th at a companion site, DCKidsFandom.com. So, why all the changes? Well, it kind of makes sense. A couple of days ago, they released an app that allowed you to make that timeline schedule. This probably gave them a preview of what fans were gravitating to. More than likely, the overwhelming amount of material was for those DCEU movies. Wonder Woman 1984, James Gunn's The Suicide Squad, The Rock's Black Adam, and Matt Reeves' The Batman are all really in high demand. Like most conferences, some of these presentations were competing with each other, so I suspect DC looked at some of the high demand stuff that wasn't in the DCEU list and decided to split it off so people would give it the proper attention. I'm not too sure how good of an idea this really, really is, but I do love the opportunity to be able to see more content. I'm just not so sure a 3-week break between the shows is such a great idea. Obviously, once we get more behind the scene details about this event, we'll bring them your way immediately. But I'm really, really curious. What do you guys think of DC Fandome being broken into two events? And does this affect your level of hype for the event that was upcoming this weekend? I gotta say, my balloon is a little deflated. Sound off in the comments below. If you like this video, make sure you press like, click subscribe, and if you don't ring that bell, you won't get any updates. Peace.